Hello, praise God, praise God. This is actually part two to, it's not a head problem, it's a heart problem. I didn't even know that they had cut it off because I was finished. So that means they went back and cut off what I was saying. Let me just go ahead and put it out there. I told you guys, whenever I'm under the anointing, which I've just come under that 40-day fast and actually still fasting, I know I'm spitting that fire. I'm not trying to be arrogant, but confident, because I know how Jesus uses me. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. The Holy Ghost be all on me, and then people can't stand it. So I actually just listen to it, you know, because sometimes I'll go back and I'll listen to my own lives, because to be honest with you, when I'm under the Holy Ghost, I really don't remember what I'm saying. So it ministered to me as well. So just now, I just got through listening to it because I had an event on Saturday. And so I rested on Sunday. And so, you know, I'm just listening to it. Just put it that way. And I said, oh, my God, they cut me off. They cut me off when I was telling you all about being in Hollywood. So I got upset and I got back up on here. So, devil, you ain't going to stop nothing, but you don't want nobody to know how y'all operate. So let me go ahead and finish that story. When I was in Hollywood, this is what they do. The men have to sleep with the men and the women have to sleep with the women. And now, because they cut me off, I'm going to go ahead and tell some more secrets that y'all not. I don't even know if y'all going to believe it, and it really don't matter. No, y'all not going to believe it. But the ones that have the spirit of the living God will. Let me tell you something. Most of you church well-known leaders are gay and they participate in the boule and all that other stuff. So you can say what you want to say. You don't understand. This world is run by Satan. You can't do nothing in this world if they don't sign off on it. Now, y'all could play games if you want to. So I'm going to finish that story. So basically, what I was saying is that when I thought God didn't want me to be famous, and because I had, believe it or not, I wrote a script. I was going to do a teen talk show. And I actually went to Oprah Studios and I presented it. Well, they rejected it because I wanted to do a religious teen talk show. You know, I want to try to save our youth out here, get them before they get in the hands of all these other people, right? And I look back, I think it was like two months later, the same script that I wanted. All I know is Keke Palmer ended up doing a teen talk show with the same outline. Now, I ain't saying nobody stole nothing. But I'm just saying, I know what I'm talking about. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. So I was going with that by saying it's not a head problem, it's a heart problem. You guys, let me tell you something. You have to choose what side you're going to be on. I thank God that he chose for me earlier in my life, because if I had taken the route that I wanted to take, I wouldn't be who I am today. I'm very transparent on purpose. And earlier in my life, I wanted to be a star. I wanted that money just like most of y'all do. Don't play games. But when I started getting seasoned with God, I said, wait a minute. I am not trying to sell my soul. I am not trying to be famous so I can go to, because I'm about to say something. I'm about to go here. When we all have gifts, when you came to earth, and you came as a spirit, believe it or not, we all have gifts. You have to, God going to give you free will. You have to choose to worship God with your gift or worship the devil with your gift. Y'all ain't ready for me. I'm going to say some hard things on here today. If y'all want to know what happened to Michael Jackson, Whitney Houston, Prince, I think you all know. You can sit up there and play crazy, but here's the deal. They gave us some good music. But now I'm going to leave y'all and ask y'all a question. Who were they supposed to glorify with their gift? Now, don't play games. Don't play games. Don't get mad. Don't like nobody judging. It's just reality. Who are you serving with your gift? Because here's how this thing goes. You have to choose to who you're going to serve your gift with. You're going to serve God or you're going to serve the devil. You can say what you want to say. That's the way this thing goes. And when I understood that, I chose God. I said, you know what? All the money in this world ain't worth my soul. Oh, come on, somebody. And I was going to finish that story before they cut me off on my other life. They asked one of the stars, me and her was friends. And I went to a house, and I've told this story before, but I'm reiterating it. And she told me, she said, and I'm going to say the whole story. Yes, I am. She told me, she said, Deanna, it's time. I said, time for what? She said, you want to be with us? And I said, yeah. Until she started all this foolishness. She said, okay, I need you to come sit down. I need you to meditate. That's what she said. I said, okay, what are we meditating on? I'm thinking it's God, right? She said, no, we're going to meditate to Mother Earth. That's what they believe. They believe in demonics, okay? So she said, I want you to focus and try to connect your tailbone with the earth. Y'all, I promise you before God. I said, oh, no. I said, hold on. I said, I don't play this. And I got so upset. I acted like a little kid. I said, I won't be your friend no more. And I never talked to her again to this day. I'm telling you the truth before God. I ain't got time to play games. This is for our souls. And that's why I think they're cutting off my lives, because they don't want y'all to know everything. Half of y'all ain't gonna believe it anyway. That's on you. I don't care. And I have to say it that way, because here's the deal. You're gonna want to do what you want to do anyway. But my position as a prophet, as an apostle, a leader of the gospel, I'm supposed to tell you what time it is. Now, whether you believe it or not, that's on you. My position is just to tell you the message. Now, that's it in the story. And all I'm saying is count the cost, people. Because I'm telling you, that money look real good. Them houses look real good. Them cars look real good. Being on TV look real good. But people are dying and going to hell. That's real too. Hallelujah. And I know people don't like to hear it because it's scary, isn't it? Isn't it scary? But how much more scary that you don't know the truth? How much more scary that you're choosing wrong because you think it's right? Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody. And I know there's some hard stuff. I get it. Trust me. I understand. I know it's unbelievable, but not really, because all you got to do is ask God to show you. I challenge every last one within the sound of my voice. Ask Jesus Christ to show you what time it is. But now hold on. You can't be scared now. Because when you ask him, he's going to show you. He's going to show you who demons, how they operate, what they do, and what they want. The enemy wants your soul. He's not playing. This is a war for souls. The enemy wants your soul, and he wants to steal you from God, especially if you are a born-again Christian. Notice what I say, a born-again Christian, because I'm going to say it like I said it in the other life. If you are not a born-again Christian, filled with the Holy Ghost, listen to what I just said, a born again Christian filled with the Holy Ghost, you are capable of anything. Because you see, only the Holy Ghost keeps us saying, don't do that, don't say that, don't go there. And even after, if we do something, we ain't got no business. The spirit of conviction will come up on you so heavy, make your head spin. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. Those that don't have restraint, you will do what the enemy wants you to do. I'm going to break something down to y'all. Did you notice that God called his disciples at first? That's because he was trying to discipline them. The root word for disciple is discipline. Later, after training, he called them apostles. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. We all got to be trained for this. You don't just get to, I want to preach and teach. Y'all wonder why people falling? Y'all wonder why the church is in disarray? Because everybody trying to do something without being trained. It took me 20 years to get here. And I'm still not perfect. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Yes, I am anointed. Yes, I can preach and teach. But every day I got to, God, keep me. God, keep me. Don't let me fall. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. You don't get to just come up and, I'm gonna give me a certificate offline. Y'all know they doing all kind of stuff. They getting their sermons offline. What they ain't doing. And then you wonder why they're falling. Because them demons are coming after you, because they're saying, Paul, I know. Jesus, I know. But who are you? Because you ain't got no power. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. So that's why they keep cutting off my lives, because I've been spending that. I could feel it. I can feel the anointing. So they don't like that. Because I was wondering, I said, now, Lord, they finishing. So how are they getting stopped? So they either cutting this stuff out, the information, or just cutting it off. But I was surprised when I heard that one just now. I was like, how the heck that? Whatever. I'm going to keep on rolling. I'm going to keep on doing what God said to do until the end. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. So I just wanted to finish this part two. God bless you. God keep you. But there's one thing that God want me to reiterate. Choose wisely who you're going to serve with your gift, people. Because I'm telling you, everything costs. And sometimes you really don't want to pay, because you can say what you want to say. Your free will. You have to choose who you serve. Choose this day, the Lord says, who will you serve, God or mammon, Satan or God? So God bless you and God keep you. This is Apostle Deanna Dixon, Roll Out Soldiers, for that is who we are. God bless.